Good morning, students. Today we are going to learn Chapter 3, Plant Kingdom. Chapter 3, Plant Kingdom. Already we had learned in second lesson about some plants, Vitagase, Spike Kingdom classification, in that Monera, Protista, Fungi, Plantae, and Animalia we had already learned. In that Plantae Kingdom, that is the fourth kingdom of Vitagase, Spike Kingdom classification, is learning very detail in this lesson, Plant Kingdom. So in previous chapter, we looked at the broad classification of living organism under the system proposed by Whittaker only. Are you remembering which are the systems of Whittaker? Five kingdom were there. They were Monera, Protista, Fungi, Plantae, and Animalia. In that Plantae only we are going to learn in detail in this lesson. Monera, Protista, Fungi, Animalia, and Plantae. In this chapter, we will deal detail with the further classification within kingdom Plantae, popularly known as the Plant Kingdom. Plantae, popularly known as the Plant Kingdom. Very easy lesson only. We must stress here that our understanding of the Plant Kingdom has changed over time. Fungi, the members of Monera, Protista having cell walls have now been excluded from Plantae through earlier classification put to them in same kingdom only. Fungi, what is the special characteristic of fungi? It does not have a chlorophyll. So it does not do photosynthesis. So fungi and members of Monera, Monera means bacteria including kingdom only, and Protista having cell walls have now been excluded from Plantae. So who are excluded from Plantae? Fungi, members of Monera, and Protista are excluded from Plantae kingdom. To earlier classification, they were included. Now, according to this classification, they were excluded. Who are excluded? Fungi, members of Monera, and Protista. Fungi, members of Monera, and Protista. So, the cyanobacteria that are also referred to as blue-green algae, the other name of cyanobacteria is blue-green algae, are not algae anymore. Now it is not remained as algae. Cyanobacteria that already referred to as blue-green algae, now it will not be considered as an algae. So in this chapter, we will describe Plantae under algae, bryophyte, pteridophyte, gymnosperm, and angiosperm. So what we are going to learn, see that algae, bryophyte, pteridophyte, gymnosperm and angiosperm learning, then lesson also will be get completed. So starting from algae, then bryophyte, pteridophyte, gymnosperm and angiosperm are the classification of Plantae kingdom, Plant Kingdom. Which are those? Algae, bryophytes, pteridophytes, gymnosperms, angiosperms. These are included in the Plantae kingdom. So let us look at the classification within angiosperm to understand some of the concerns that influenced the classification system. The earliest system of classification used only gross superficial morphological characters such as habit, color, number, and shape of leaves, etc. only. The earliest system of classification only goes with the superficial characters only. What is meant by superficial? The characters which you can see externally. By seeing external appearance like habit, color, number, and shape of leaves. So on the basis of that only the earlier classification was there. They were based mainly on vegetative characters. Vegetative characters means arrangement of leaf, stem, root, on these characters only. Or on the andrisium structure. That is, the system given by Linnaeus was based on the andrisium structure. What is andrisium? Andrisium is the male reproductive structure of a male flower only. Male reproductive structure of a flower is andrisium. So, what was the limitation of earlier system? Earlier system of classification only seen on superficial characters only. External characters like habit, color, number, and shape of leaves. Some vegetative characters or on the shape of andrisium and number of the stamen, on the basis of that also classification done. Such a system were artificial only. Such a systems were artificial means only considering external characters or vegetative characters. They separated the closely related species also according to this classification, this type of artificial classification. They separated the closely related species since they were based on a few characteristics only. Very closely related species also gone to different classification according to this artificial system of classification because it only based on superficial characters. Because of that, what a difficulty came? Because of that, very close related organism also came into different classification. Understood? Also, the artificial system gave equal weightage to vegetative and sexual characteristics. This is not acceptable since we know that often the vegetative characters are more easily affected by environment. And second limitation of artificial system. Now we are learning the answer of an important question only. What are the limitation of artificial system of classification? First, already I told that first limitation is that it only give important to superficial morphological characters only. Superficial morphological characters like habit, color, number, and shape of leaves. They were based mainly on vegetative characters or on the andrecium structure. Such a system were artificial. They were so closely related species since they were based on a few characteristics. Also, the artificial system gave equal weightage to vegetative and sexual characteristics. This is not acceptable since we know that often the vegetative characters are more easily affected by environment. Because vegetative characters are more easily affected by the environment. Environment, when temperature increases, then leaves are curling, some trees are shedding their leaves. These all are affected by environment. Which side light comes through, that side the stem will change. So that characters we cannot consider because it is changed by the environment only. Second, understood all of you. The second limitation is that the artificial system gave equal weightage to vegetative and sexual characteristics. This is not acceptable since we know by the environment. As against this, natural classification system developed. Against this, which classification system? Because of these two limitations of artificial system of classification, a new classification arose that was very natural only, so it got the name natural classification system. As against this, natural classification system developed, which were based on natural affinities among the organism, which were based on natural affinities among the organism and consider natural affinities among organism and consider not only the external features but also internal features like ultrastructure, anatomy, embryology and phytochemistry. Not only the external features but also internal features like ultrastructure, anatomy, and anatomy means internal structure, embryology, embryo formation and its development, and phytochemistry. What are the chemical components present in that? So this natural system of classification, the advantage of natural system of classification, it not only give the external features but also consider the internal features also. But artificial system only consider the external features, but natural system but not only consider the external features but also consider internal features like ultrastructure, anatomy means internal structure, embryology means formation of embryo and its development, and phytochemistry means chemical components present inside the cell. Such a classification for flowering plants was given by George Bentham and Joseph Dalton Hooker. The credit of natural classification for flowering plants. Credit of natural classification for flowering plants goes to George Bentham and Joseph Dalton Hooker. So this is also calling as Bentham and Hooker's classification. George Bentham and Joseph Dalton Hooker. So this classification, natural classification, is also known as Bentham and Hooker's classification. So students, today this one we had already learned two type of classification: artificial system of classification and a natural system of classification. Because of two limitations of artificial system of classification, a new classification arises, that is the natural system of classification. The credit of this natural classification is that it not only give the external features but also consider the internal features like ultrastructure, anatomy, embryology, phytochemistry. Such a classification for flowering plants was given by George Bentham and Joseph Dalton Hooker. So on the respect of these two, this system is also calling as Bentham and Hooker's classification. Got it? Now we are going to another type of classification, that is phylogenetic classification only. Phylogenetic classification. Now we are following this classification only. Phylogenetic classification. So this is based on evolutionary relationships only. This phylogenetic classification is based on evolutionary relationship. Which organism is evolved from which one? Like that, we are knowing that reptiles are evolved from amphibia. Like that, which organism are evolved from which one? Like that, importance is given to phylogenetic classification system. So phylogenetic classification system based on evolutionary relationships between the various organisms are acceptable. This assumes that organisms belonging to the same taxa have a common ancestor. Organisms belonging to the same taxa have a common ancestor. We now use information from many other sources to help resolve difficulties in classification. Resolve difficulties in classification. These become more important when there is no supporting fossil evidence. We now use information from many other sources to help resolve difficulties in classification. These become more important when there is no supporting fossil evidence. Numerical taxonomy, which is now easily carried out using computers, is based on all observable characters only. Numerical taxonomy, see that. Numerical taxonomy, which is now easily carried out using computers, is based on all observable characters only. As the name indicates, it will give importance to number and codes only, because numerical taxonomy only. Taxonomy means classification. So, which is now easily carried out using computers, is based on all observable characters. Number and codes are assigned to all the characters and the data are then processed. In this way, each character is given equal importance, and at the same time, hundreds of characters can be considered. At the same time, hundreds of characters can be considered. Cytotaxonomy, that is based on cytological information like chromosome number, structure, behavior, and chemotaxonomy, that uses the chemical constituents, the plants, to resolve confusions, are also used by taxonomists these days only. So number and codes are assigned to numerical taxonomy and data are then processed. In this way, each character is given equal importance and at the same time, hundreds of characters can be considered. Next taxonomy is cytotaxonomy, that is based on cytological information like chromosome number, structure of chromosome, behavior of organism. These three are coming under cytotaxonomy. Chromosome number, structure, behavior are coming under cytotaxonomy. So cytotaxonomy, that is based on cytological information like chromosome number, structure, behavior, and chemotaxonomy giving importance to. What is chemo? Means chemical only. So chemotaxonomy uses the chemical constituents of the plant to resolve confusions, are also used by taxonomists these days only. So three type of taxonomy nowadays using by the scientists. numerical taxonomy giving importance to number and codes. Cytotaxonomy giving importance to chromosome number, structure and behavior. Chromosome number, structure and behavior. Chemotaxonomy giving importance to chemical constituents of the plant. To resolve confusions are also used by taxonomists these days. So, phylogenetic three type of classification learned: artificial system of classification, natural system of classification, and phylogenetic system of classification. Now we are following the phylogenetic system of classification because it gives importance to evolutionary relationship. Do you know evolution? Evolution means one organism is evolved from which other organism, and what are the improved characters in that organism, what are the prevailing characters in an organism, that all coming under evolution. Evolution we will learn in 12th standard. So this assumes that organism belonging to the same taxa have a common ancestor only. Organism belonging to the same taxa, the people belonging to the same house having common ancestor, no, like that. If organism belonging to the same taxa have a common ancestor. Common ancestor, now we now use information from many other sources to help resolve difficulties in classification. These become more important when there is no supporting fossil evidence. This classification is important in which situation more? When there is no supporting fossil evidence. Understood. So now we are going to learn first classification of plant kingdom, that is algae. Already we had learned in the last lesson. It is when we had learned about the lichen, we learned that algae and fungi. Lichen is a combination of algae and fungi. Here we are going to very detail about algae. Algae, already I told you that algae are chlorophyll bearing only. Chlorophyll bearing. Fungi was not bearing the chlorophyll, so it is removed from the, according to new classification, fungi removed from the plant kingdom. So algae are chlorophyll bearing. Chlorophyll bearing means chlorophyll containing, simple, thalloid, autotrophic, and largely aquatic organisms only. Thalloid means, thalloid is a new word maybe for you. Thalloid means the plant body of the plant, which does not differentiate into root, stem, and leaf. Understood. While we seeing a plant, we know that which is the leaf portion of the plant, which is the stem, which is the root, like that we can understand easily. But for a thalloid, we cannot distinguish, we cannot differentiate which is stem, root, or leaf. So the definition of thalloid is that a plant body which is not differentiated into root, stem, and leaf. A plant body which is not differentiated into root, stem, and leaf only. Autotrophic, everybody knowing, and largely aquatic means living in water only, that both freshwater and marine organisms. They occur in a variety of other habitat. They can live in other places also, like moist stones, soils, and wood. Some also occur along with the fungi that already we had learned that it is Polygnus lichen, and animals, on animals also they can be live, that is sloth bear. So what we learned about the algae? Algae are chlorophyll bearing, simple, thalloid, autotrophic, and largely aquatic in habitat. They occur a variety of other habitat like moist stones. They can live on moist stone also, on soil also, wood also. But it should be moist because it is an aquatic organism. Moist stone, moist soil, and moist. Some of them also occur on, in association with the fungi, that is lichen, and in association with the animal, that is the sloth bear. The form and size of algae is highly variable only. The size ranges from microscopic unicellular forms like Chlamydomonas to colonial forms like Volvox. The size ranges from, the smallest one is microscopic unicellular form. That is Chlamydomonas is the smallest among algae. Microscopic it is. Microscopic means it can see only through microscope. Microscopic unicellular forms like Chlamydomonas Two colonial forms. What is meant by colony? Colony means some organism, more than two, three organism or more organism living together is called a colony. Colony means more organism living together. So colonial form is the wall box. So microscopic unicellular form is the Chlamydomonas. Unicellular algae asking then Chlamydomonas, and colonial algae asking then wall box. And to the filamentous form also. Filamentous form, which is the filamentous form? Eulothrix and Spirogyra. Filamentous form is Eulothrix and Spirogyra. So four name of algae we had learned now. What is Chlamydomonas? That is a unicellular microscopic algae. And Wallbox, that is a colonial form of algae. And Eulothrix and Spirogyra are filamentous form of algae. A few of the marine forms such as gulls for massive plant bodies only. A few of the marine form, this is a marine algae only, gulls for massive plant bodies spread all over the sea. Marine means sea only. It will be look like a mat on the sea like that. It is very massive plant body only. Massive means a very spreaded form only. It look like a mat on the sea only. Which is that for marine form? Gulls. K-E-L-P-S. So algae reproduce by vegetative, asexual and sexual methods. Algae reproduce by vegetative, asexual and sexual methods. Vegetative reproduction is by fragmentation. Fragment means small, small pieces. First, the organism will be divided into small pieces, and afterwards every piece will be developed as a complete organism. Each fragment develops into thallus. Asexual reproduction is by the production of different type of spores. Spores also producing, the spores are called zoospores. They are flagellated. If they are motile, they are having a flagella, and on germination give rise to new plants. Sexual reproduction takes place through fusion of two gametes. These gametes can be flagellated. Sexual reproduction is there, then fusion of gamete will be there. That male gamete fused to the female gamete. These gametes can be flagellated and similar in size as in Chlamydomonas, or non-flagellated, that is non-motile but similar in size as in Spirogyra. Size similar means both male gamete and female gamete having same size only, no difference. Such a reproduction is called isogamous. Iso means same only. Gamous means gametes. Both the gametes having same size, then it is called isogamous. Both the gametes, that is male gamete and female gamete having same size, then it is called isogamous. Fusion of two gametes dissimilar in size. Fusion of two gametes dissimilar in size as in some species of Chlamydomonas is termed as anisogamous. In anisogamous is the opposite of isogamous only. Isogamous means both male gamete and female gamete having same size. And anisogamous means if they are having different size. In that majority time, female gametes are larger in size. Female gametes are larger in size only. Fusion between one large and non-motile female gamete and a smaller motile gamete is termed as oogamous. Fusion between one large and non-motile means not moving, static means stationary at one place, female gamete and smaller motile male gamete is termed as oogamous. Diagram also given here. Algae are useful to man in variety of ways. At least a half of the total carbon dioxide fixation on earth is carried out by algae through photosynthesis. Being photosynthetic, they increase the level of dissolved oxygen in their immediate environment. Algae are useful to man in variety of ways. Now, this paragraph is what are the uses of algae. At least a half of the total carbon dioxide fixation on earth is carried out by algae through photosynthesis. As algae are doing photosynthesis, they take the carbon dioxide from the atmosphere. That is called the carbon dioxide fixation. Being photosynthetic, they increase the level of dissolved oxygen in their immediate environment. They are of paramount importance as primary producers of energy-rich compounds, which form the basis of food cycle. They are primary producers also. food cycle of all aquatic animals are starting from algae only, because all other organisms living in water eating this algae only. So being producers of energy rich compounds which form the basis of food cycle. Food cycle, are you heard food cycle? Food cycle will be started, especially for aquatic forms, food cycle will be started from algae only. Many species, Porphyra, Laminaria, Sargassum, are among 70 species of marine algae used as food also. So marine food included Porphyra, Laminaria and Sargassum. This name you have to by heart. Certain marine brown and red algae produce large amount of hydrocolloids. Hydrocolloids, hydro means water. Colloid means holding substances. Hydrocolloids, water holding substance. Algae, brown algae and carrageen, red algae are used as commercial. So certain marine brown and red algae produce large amounts of hydrocolloids, that is water holding substance. And example, algae, brown algae and carrageen, red algae are used commercially as a hydrocolloid for water holding substance, water absorbing substance. One of the commercial products obtained from Gelidium and Gracilaria used to grow microbes in preparations of ice cream and jellies. This is known as China grass. Gelidium and Gracilaria are used to grow microbes and in preparation of ice cream and jellies. Chlorella and spirulina are unicellular algae rich in protein and are used in food supplements even by space travelers only. For who are going to the space, if they cannot be afford other food, space only, space traveling consumes much month and year. So chlorella and spirulina, unicellular algae rich in proteins, are used as food supplements even by space travelers. The algae are divided into three main classes: chlorophyceae, pyophyceae and rhodophyceae. That we will learn afterwards. These are the uses of algae. Algae are very useful only. Now I will show some slides to you. So three type of classification: artificial system, natural system and phylogenic system. Artificial system, natural system and phylogenic system, that already we had learned. Now artificial system is proposed by Carl Linnaeus only, earliest system of classification. They were based on vegetative characters or superficial morphological characters such as habit, color, number and shape of leaves, etc. Linnaeus artificial system of classification was based on Andrician structure only. This is about the artificial classification system. Now, what are the delimitation or drawback of artificial system? They separated the closely related species since they were based on a few characters. Equal weightage to vegetative and sexual characteristics. This is not acceptable since the vegetative characters are more easily affected by environment. Next classification, natural system of classification. These are based on natural affinities among organisms. It considers external features and internal features, that is ultrastructure, anatomy, embryology and phytochemistry. Example, classification for flowering plants given by George Bentham and Joseph Dalton Hooker. Third classification is the phylogenetic classification, like that different phylum formed from which one. These are based on evolutionary aspects only, evolutionary aspects. This assumes that organism in the same taxa have a common ancestor. This assumes that organism in the same taxa have a common ancestor. And this one, numerical taxonomy, it is based on all observable characters. It is carried out using computers. Number and codes are assigned to all characters and the data are processed. These hundreds of characters can be equally considered. Cytotaxonomy, based on cytological information like a chromosome number. This is cytological chromosome number, chromosome only shown here. Number, structure and behavior. and this is chemotaxonomy, chemical constituents of the plant. This is numerical taxonomy, like that numbering and codes are, number and codes are given in numerical taxonomy. This is cytotaxonomy, cytological information like a chromosome number, structure and behavior. This is chemotaxonomy, number, characters, numerical taxonomy, cytotaxonomy, chromosome number, structure and behavior. This is chemical constituents of the cell, chemical constituents. Algae I will show you afterwards. So plant kingdom, this is the lesson we are learning now, plant kingdom. Seeing the plants around us, and next one is three system of classification, artificial, natural system and phylogenetic system. And next one, the artificial classification system based on what? And next one, drawbacks means limitation. What are the demerits or drawbacks or limitation of artificial system of classification put forward by Carl Linnaeus? And next one, natural system of classification, George Bentham, Joseph Dalton Hooker only prepared this one. So this is also knowing on Bentham and Hooker's classification. External features as well as internal features are included in this one. And phylogenetic classification. And this one only. So I think that all of you understood it nicely. And we will, in the next session, we will continue with the algae.